The Washington Post recently highlighted a study that says charts change hearts and minds better than words do. It's easier to read than say. So Steve Rattner, go ahead. Change our hearts and minds and tell us about the border crisis.
Well, I'm not sure I can change our hearts and minds better than some of those pictures did, which were so incredibly wrenching, but I'll try to do better than words anyway. So look, let's try to dissect some of what Trump is saying, because as usual, it's filled with a number of falsehoods, starting with his claim that the number of people crossing the border has exploded. And so what you can see, what he's talking about is he's comparing what's happening this year in terms of border apprehensions to what happened last year in 2017. But what he's ignoring is the fact that in three other previous years, the rate of apprehensions was roughly the same as it is now. So if you take out last year as an aberration, there's really no particular change in the number of people trying to cross the border. And in fact, this is also kind of a seasonal high, and generally this declines as the year wears on. So that's sort of lie number one that we can put to rest. The second question is, where does this stand relative to history? And if you go back in history, you can see that the number of border crossings in the last several years has been at the lowest level it's been since 1971. If you go back to the year 2000, it was up over 1.6 million. And so it is possible, if you look at the little extrapolation we did here, that the number of border crossings could be slightly higher this year than it was last year, but we're bumping along in a bottom for a variety of reasons. The financial crisis caused a lot of people from Mexico to decide the U.S. wasn't actually such a great place to come after all. Things in Mexico, notwithstanding some of what we saw there, but in the broader Mexican economy have gotten better. There are more jobs, more things for people to do. And so, in fact, the number of people trying to cross the border has generally been trending down.
Is any of that, Steve, tied to policy? In other words, President Obama, who President Trump accuses of having been weak on immigration, weak at the border, it is the economy, yes, but is there something that President Obama did to bring about that sort of precipitous drop during his two terms?
Actually, it was, yes, in fact, I didn't show it in this graph, but if you looked at the number of Border Patrol agents that have been assigned to the border, it's been going up sharply over the last 15 years. It's down a little bit lately because I think some budget cuts, but it had been rising very sharply. So yes, we've done a lot more to enforce the border. And in fact, Obama did consider policies like what Trump is doing, but rejected the idea of separating families, but he did step up the enforcement of the border of people trying to cross illegally. But then lastly, let's deal with this question of whether the people who come here, as Trump famously said, are rapists, murderers, and carrying drugs, and a few good people, and look at what the record is of immigrants who actually come to the country. So what you can see here is that illegal immigrants actually are incarcerated at half the rate of native-born Americans, and legal immigrants are actually incarcerated at an even lower rate than that. And so this whole notion that we're bringing in gang members, we're bringing in people who are going to rape, murder, and pillage our country is simply not borne out by the facts.
All right, Steve, thank you so much. Coming up, the U.S. government says it seeks to promote, quote, humane international migration policies. But when asked if the Trump separation policy was humane, the acting director of ICE couldn't bring himself to use the word. We'll have his dance around the issue ahead. Plus, current and former law enforcement officials send letters demanding the Trump administration end the policy. We'll talk to the Attorney General of New Mexico and a former U.S. attorney, lending their voices to the cause. We'll be right back.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.